on a show. He finds the back of the cage. Building buzzing on the road.
Round of the 2023 NHL draft went down last night in Nashville, and we're gonna take a look at some of the top picks that went in the first round. Definitely a lot of mix-ups for sure, and some guys you wouldn't expect to be picked, and some guys dropping as well. So we're going to take a look at the top picks here in round one that went down last night. Now, at number one, the obvious pick, Chicago takes Connor Bedard first overall. I mean, come on, it was already locked in. We all knew Bedard was going number one. But at number two here, Anaheim Ducks take Leo Carlson. Now, a lot of people thought they would have took Adam Fantilli, including myself. I did think Anaheim was going to take Adam Fantilli. But Leo Carlson is a really, really good player as well. A really good Swedish player. I watched him play in the World Juniors on TV. Really skilled player, and that's a really good pick for Anaheim as well. At number three, like I just said, Adam Fantilli drops one spot down to number three and goes to the Columbus Blue Jackets. Like I said, Fantilli's a really great player too. Played for the University of Michigan this year. Also won gold at the World Juniors with Connor Bedard, and won gold with Canada recently at the World Hockey Championship. So two gold medals in 1 year. Pretty impressive. At number four, Will Smith goes to San Jose Sharks. Now, I thought San Jose would have took Matvei Michkov, but they go with Will Smith. Another good pick for San Jose. At number five, this is where it got pretty funny. A lot of people thought Montreal would take Matvei Michkov also. A lot of reporters thought that Montreal was going to go with Michkov because they had interviews with him. And apparently they went well, I guess. But this was pretty funny for Montreal's pick because they brought out Carey Price to make the pick. And he didn't know how to pronounce the last name of this guy's name. They didn't know how to he didn't know how to pronounce his last name, or he just forgot what his last name was. But he looked very embarrassed and shocked for sure. But David Reinbacher goes to Montreal at number five. Big defenseman, he's 6'2", 193 or 194 pounds, something like that. But a really good defenseman that will be good for them in a couple years for sure. Montreal has a really good young prospect pool, and they're going to look really good in the next couple years. At number six, Dmitry Simashev goes to the Arizona Coyotes, a defenseman there. And at number seven, a big pick for the Flyers, a really, really good pick for them, as they take Matvei Michkov at number seven. That is a really great pick by the Flyers. Obviously, a year ago, Mishkov was in talks with Bedard. It was Bedard and Mishkov as number one, number two talk. But then COVID happened and it kind of messed up the rankings a bit. But Matvei Mishkov goes number seven to the Flyers, and that is an absolutely great pick by the Flyers. A lot of reporters are comparing him to a next Ovi. He's definitely a really skilled player, has good hands, good skating, great shot also. So that's a really good pick for the Flyers. At number eight, the Washington Capitals pick Ryan Leonard. Number nine, the Detroit Red Wings select Nate Danielson. A really good pick there. Nate Danielson is a really, really good forward in the WHL. Played with the Brandon Wheat Kings. At number 10, the St. Louis Blues select Dalibor Dvorsky. Now, I actually got to watch him play in person at the World Juniors, because I didn't go to any Canada games. Those were just too expensive and hard to get tickets to. But I did go to some Czechia games and a lot of Ever games, a lot of Ever countries too. And I remember watching Dvorsky play, and he was a really good player as well. So good pick by St. Louis there. Vancouver at number 11 picks a Swedish player, Tom Wilander. Really good pick there too. He said as a kid he grew up a big fan of the Sedin brothers, and he was a big Canucks fan growing up, so now he's a member of them, so pretty cool story there. At number 12, Arizona selects Daniel Booth. At 13, Buffalo gets a really good pick with Zach Benson. A lot of people had him ranked higher, around 5th or 6th, but he drops number 13 to Buffalo, so big pickup by Buffalo there. At number 14, the Pittsburgh Penguins select a really good forward as well in Braden Jaeger. Really skilled guy there. Great pick for Pittsburgh. They got some good future pieces as well. Number 15, Nashville picks Matthew Wood. At 16, Calgary Flames select Samuel Honzik. Never really good player. And at number 17, my Detroit Red Wings. I'm really happy about this pick. I kind of expected us to get this guy at number 9, but I'm happy we got him at 17, and that is Axel Sandin Pelika, who is a defenseman, and that's what the Red Wings need. We need some defensemen, and Axel Sandin Pelika, I watched highlights of him and clips. He's a really good defenseman, really skilled with the puck. Great skating, great hands, everything, you name it. At number 18, this is another guy I thought could have went number 9 to Detroit also. But the Winnipeg Jets at number 18 select Colby Barlow. A really, really, you're going to hear me say this a lot, but really skilled player, great shot in everything, like I said before. Just, he's one of the best players to come out of the OHL in this draft. So really good pick there for Winnipeg, who's also rebuilding their team. Chicago at number 19 selects Oliver Moore. Seattle at number 20 selects Edward Sale. I got to watch him play in person at the World Juniors too. A never really good player. Pretty tall guy too. So some good size there for Seattle. At 21, Minnesota selects Charlie Strommel. 22, Philly selects Oliver Bonk. At 23, the Rangers select Gabriel Perreault. 24, Nashville gets a really good defenseman here with Tanner Molendijk. I heard lots of good things about him. 25, St. Louis Blues select Otto Stenberg. I heard good things about him too and how good of a player he can be. At 26, San Jose Sharks select Quentin Musty. 27, Colorado Avalanche select Callum Ritchie. At 28, Toronto selects Easton Cowan. 29, St. Louis selects Theo Linestein. And at number 30, Carolina selects Bradley Nadeau. At 31, Colorado selects Mikhail Guliev. And with the last pick in the first round, the Stanley Cup champions, Vegas Golden Knights, select David Edstrom. So there you go. That's all your picks from the first round that went down last night. Now, at the time I'm recording this video, the draft rounds 2 to 7 are this afternoon at 12 p.m. So we'll see how those picks go, but I most likely won't have a video on that. But if there's any trades that happen, which there most likely will be, there was no trades in the first round this year, which was the first time in a long time that that's ever happened. But if there's any big trades, I will most likely have videos up on that. But without further ado, that's gonna wrap up this round one draft recap. So hope you guys enjoyed watching this video, and best of luck to your team in the draft. Hopefully your team gets some more good draft picks. And yeah, good luck to everyone's team in the draft. And soon we'll have free agency coming up in the next few weeks. So it's a busy week for the NHL. So lots of news to look forward to. Once again, thank you guys for watching. And be sure, if you're new to the channel and you like the content I put out, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe. Really means a lot to the channel, and I really appreciate your guys' support. Thank you so much, and I'll see you guys in the next one.